Hey guys, welcome to Rihanna's Lens, where I interact with you about the components in the STEM field and introduce you to fascinating people who passionately inhabit the scientific and technical frontiers of our society. My name is Rihanna Malhotra, and I'm absolutely elated to share this podcast with you. On this episode, I will be discussing about the evolution of robots throughout the years. In a 1940s movie, Rollo the robot butler caters to a housewife's every whim.
Rollo, answer the door.
Her helpful chrome-plated companion seems like a dream come true. But not everyone likes the idea of a mechanical manservant. In 1940, a robot butler was only a daydream. But since then, we have made robots a vital part of our lives. In 2021, we share Earth with an estimated 9 million robots. About 3 million work in factories, but they're also out on American roads in the form of self-driving cars. As robots get faster, smarter, and stronger, they improve our lives, but will they make humanity redundant? Popular cultures often showcase robots as helpful assistants or either dangerous killers. Most robot stories at the time were Frankenstein tales where robots destroy their own masters. So in 1940, an iconic sci-fi writer, Isaac Asimov, set out a moral code for them. One that will influence how we think about robots for decades to come.
The first law is as follows. A robot may not harm a human being or through inaction allow a human being to come to harm. Number two, a robot must obey orders given it by qualified personnel unless those orders violate rule number one. In other words, a robot can't be ordered to kill a human being. Rule number three, a robot must protect its own existence, after all it's an expensive piece of equipment, unless that violates rules one or two. A robot must cheerfully go into self-destruction if it is in order to follow an order or to save a human life.
His laws are simply fictional, but they inspired real-world engineers to create their first truly helpful robot. Robots were often suited to do repetitive tasks in assembly line. If robots are going to help humans with more complicated work, they needed to start thinking for themselves. They need some sort of artificial intelligence. Since the 1960s, researchers have been exploring the idea of a robot guided by AI software, one that can think for itself. This dream first took shape at the Stanford Research Institute. The robot sent signals to its computer brain in the next room, allowing the robot to deal with unpredictable circumstances. They tested the sensors regularly by placing obstacles on its path. The robot's program was a milestone in artificial intelligence, a platform where more different and complex algorithms will be built. By 1990s, the computers became far more powerful and AI only got smarter. Especially just when a man was outwitted by a computer in a game of chess. These computers are only getting better by the minute because of the amount of transistors that are being squeezed onto microchips roughly doubles every 2 years exponentially, increasing their speed and capacity. By the late 90s, computing power was compact enough that AI programs could be installed in robots. It was a huge development. Robots now had decision-making abilities and could take on more complicated tasks that were too dangerous for humans. Robots were even going to places where humans had never gone before, like Mars at that time. In the 2000s, firms started making robots to reduce human loneliness and increase interactions. In 2013, a robot even accompanied an astronaut to space. They spent 18 months together and shared everything. Robots started helping kids with autism as they were made more friendlier. Humans all over the world are turning to intelligent robots for emotional support. The robots seem to be coming for everyone's jobs. And as they become better at navigating our world, the prospects of putting advanced intelligent programs inside of them seems more and more unsettling. If an AI is made that can develop another AI, then there will be all sorts of inventions beyond humanity's wildest dreams. Such concepts may seem far-fetched, but so were robot butlers in 1940. When AI does outsmart us and robots take on more human functions, will we lose our purpose? How will we cope with this new world order? And who will be in control? Thank you so much for tuning in. This has been an interesting episode, and I'm looking forward to the next one to discuss further on STEM fields. Make sure you share this pod with your friends if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned!